Alright, so in this video, I'm going to show you a popular software called Fuzzy Finder. In short, it is called FZF. Specifically, I'll show you the steps it required to get binded with Vim. All the steps you needed to get it binded with Vim so you can use it efficiently with Vim. Okay, so I'm basically trying to quoting out the author's recommendation. Okay, so without further ado, let me spawn up a terminal and move it to a designated place. Let us zoom in so people can see. So I have a file. FZF, if I can type. Okay, so this is a file. I just point out all the stuffs required to get binded with Vim. So let me start with that. So the first thing, you are supposed to know, and I'm expecting you know, to install plugin in a Vim, right? So if you do, so you basically have to write these two specific line. Let me highlight it for you. These two line in your Vimrc, in the very first thing you have to do to FZF to work with Vim. Okay, so this line, these two line has to go into your Vimrc. Okay, all right. So now the second thing is that you are supposed to have this variable set in your Vimrc. Okay, so it clearly state FZF default option. Okay, which is having inline info, and it is meaning the moment you place your cursor on a specific FZF search file, it will show you the file content or information on a window. Okay, so that's the purpose of it. So basically you have to set this variable in your Vimrc. Okay, the next one is I binded my fuzzy searching inside Vim with the mapping control F. It could be different to you. So how do I bring it? If I press control F, it simply bring this kind of searching things. This is a fuzzy finder searching inside Vim. So on the left hand side, it shows the enlisting of file in which I'm in the directory, and on the right hand side, if you put your cursor on any of the file, on the right hand side the preview window will show you the content of the file. Super convenient, right? I press control F to get these things come up inside Vim. Okay, to go out of this mode, just press control C. Okay, so the binding could be different to you. And the next one is, so it says beeline. So it basically and although the binding showing the similar like previous one, all, and I haven't done so I can show you that how it basically show you the lines where you want to go. Okay, so if I go to the ex prompt and line beelines, see it open up a window on the bottom of the window or wherever you place, and it will point to each and every line of this file. Okay, and you can go to select whatever the line if you want to go. Okay, if I placed it, it will place my cursor exactly the line I chosen from that window. I hope you are following, right? Beeline is a function in FZF. If you invoke it, it will open up a window and ask you to choose the specific line of the buffer where you are located. Okay, and if you select those line, it will allow you to go to that specific line in that buffer. As simple as that. All right, the next one is, it clearly state, always enable preview window on the right with 60% width. 60% width of the entire screen width, okay? To my case, it has to have a variable assigned in your vMercy, which is FZF preview window, and it has to have this value. In my case, it is right and 60% width, as you can see. I have highlighted it, right? As you can see, it could be different to you. You can write it bottom, it can write it left, or you can enhance or decrease the width of the preview window. Okay, so basically it's up to you to decide how big the preview window, okay, will be. Preview window is like this. Control F, and if I bring out this on the right hand side, this square is called preview window. So you can adjust the width with that variable. Okay, so in my case, it is 60% of the width of the screen. In your case, it could be different as per your liking. So this variable FZF preview window is for that, to adjust the location and the width of the window. All right. So the next one is, it says buffer, and it simply, it show you if you have n number of buffer open, it will show you that buffers, okay? So and it will enlist you all the buffers with the fuzzy finder like stuff. So if I go here, if I create another window, and if I go here and I just what happened? Oh, I open up a zero length file. Wonderful. Okay, so okay, so now if I go to the EX prompt and if I write buffers, and it will show you like this. You see, it will give you an window to select, and it will give you the preview window again, right? You see it, the utility of it is simply provide you an listing of buffers and the preview window. Okay, to go out of this mode, just press Control C, and okay, so we are back. Now the next thing is that it is called B commits. These are all FZF commands or functionality. Okay, so you can use it inside Vim. So next thing is called B commits, which is nothing but a git log can be seen with the help of FZF inside Vim. Okay, so let me expand it. So it clearly state, let me highlight it, so you can see clearly there is a variable called FZF commit log options, and it simply call up some git log related stuff. It will show you the graph and always format and all these stuffs, right? All this stuff, I'm trying to say that this format section could be could be different as per your liking. You can change this if you know what you are doing. So basically change the color and all this stuff. So the purpose of this variable is to show you the git log stuff with the help of FZF inside Vim. I believe I'm very clear, right? So let me show you that. It is called bcommits. Okay. So for that, I need to change the directory where I am at this moment. It's not a git directory, so I need to change it. So I'm changing in one of my git repo. Okay, so once I have changed it, so I want to open a file. So I have opened a file inside a git repo, say a, and I wanted to see the commits of this particular file. Okay, so all I have to do, go to the ex prompt. You can bind this command. I have other binding. I'm showing you manually so you can understand it. Binding a key with this function is pretty easy. Okay, I'm showing you to you by hand so you can understand. Just write bcommits, okay, on the ex prompt and press enter. See, this is how and it has got some useful, you can see left hand side bottom that if you press Control S, it will toggle the shorting. Control Y will copy the commit hash. Control D to show you the diff. So I have two things. So if there is a preview window also, so you can see if you are inside a git repo and if you open a file with Vim which is having FZF integrated, you can call up bcommits function of FZF to see the git log in a preview window along with other option, as you can see on the bottom of the screen. Super useful, right? It's very useful to me. So to go out of this mode, just press Control C and simply go back there. Okay, so I'm going to again open to changing my directory and trying to open the file. Okay, so here now the next thing is that it says tagging. Okay, so it's C tags. If you use this tags command in FZF, it will do the tagging for you. Okay, so you have to set this variable in your vmercy to get it to work. Okay, I haven't bothered to, but you could do so because I did my tagging, or I have other plugin to do the stuff for me. But you could do with FZF because the facility is there. All right. So the next one is, this is FZF completion method, and it work in insert mode. If you press Control X, Control K, it will complete the word according to the default dictionary it search, which is located in user share dict and the file, dictionary file. Okay, and Control X, Control F complete the path completion of a specific file. Okay, and Control X, Control L to complete the line. Okay, so these are FZF completion in insert mode. You can do can show you something. Say if my as you see, I have written insert INS, okay, and I want to complete that word. Control X, Control K. So it popped up a window with all the words, right? You see, you can select from this word. Okay, this is FCF way of completing a word. It will bring up a window full of word, different word. Okay, and you can select from anywhere. If you press enter, it will simply enter that word here. You got it, right? So to complete a word in insert mode, just type the few letter of a particular word, then you have to press Control X, Control K. Okay, if say for instance, if I go back to the insert mode, and if I write, I'm doing it again, INS, and then Control X, Control K. See, it bring out a pop-up window with lot of option related to all started with INS. So if you press enter any one of them, that will get inserted or auto completed. Convenient, right? So that's the purpose way. Okay, so now if I write something, my auto completion work in different fashion. I do not use FZF completion, but you could. So for instance, if I write home, and it automatically takes like that, but you could do so by pressing Control X, Control F, so it will bring out this fuzzy finder of that particular directory. Okay, so and you can choose your file from here. You got it, right? Control X, Control F bring a fuzzy finder of finding the file path, so you can insert it. To go out of this mode, just press Control C. Anyway, my file finder using is something else. Likewise, you can the line completion method is something which will, this is if I press Control X, Control L, it has got nothing. The line completion will work if you have got similar kind of line, it will automatically complete that line for you. Okay, so if I press Control C to go out, so this is line one. Okay, now if I write this again, this is just write this much. Okay, and then Control X, Control L. See, look at the bottom of the screen. It prompt me and show me a fuzzy finder with the line completion method. If I press enter, it get filled up, right? This could be done without this plugin, but this plugin will give you the convenience to do it in a much efficient or easy way. Okay, I hope you are getting the point. So this is what basically this completion method works. Okay, the next is that you saw how the word completion done with a pop-up window come up and window full of words starting with the initial letter you type. Okay, I just shown you. Okay, the last one is so these are the FZF way of getting map. We have different mapping, normal mode mapping, insert mode mapping, operation mode mapping. Okay, to if you wanted to see the normal mode mapping just to leader tab. See what happened. See, this is the normal mode mapping which come in a FZF window, so you can search it here. Okay, so basically you can go out of this mode like every other mode by pressing Ctrl C. So all these three lines will show you the mapping of that particular mode. If I press leader and tab, it will simply show you all the mappings related to that particular tab, related to that particular mode. So this plugin will add convenient to your Vim workflow. As I mentioned once before, that you could do all this stuff without this plugin, but having this plugin will certainly give you a more convenience to do things in a easy manner. Okay, that's why I'm making this video. That's the whole point of making this video. Okay, so basically FZF will integration with Vim will allow you to add convenience to your Vim experience. Okay, I hope this video will help some people who use Vim day-to-day basis like me, okay, and have integration with FZF. Okay, thanks for watching.